All right, guys, I'm here with Amanda, and one question that I get asked often on the phone, how many classes do I need to take to be really good? Like, how many classes, salsa classes? So first of all...
Only one.
Only one class. Thank you very much.
That's it.
All right, so one thing first that we have to say, that being good is relative, right?
Absolutely.
Very relative. So somebody can say, this person is good, that person is good, I think I'm good, but maybe you're not. So it's really relative, right? So, but sometimes some people want to know the competence level that we need to be able to dance, right? So first of all, if let's say you want to go to dance at a party, okay? We want to dance in Cuba, you know, on a vacation. So I think about, to be honest, a good 6 months, you know, 6 months is a decent amount to feel comfortable to dance. So one thing I like to say is that you always dance a level lower on a social setting than the level you're doing in a class. So don't expect to be dancing the new moves right away. You have to kind of own them a bit and then you can pull them off. Now, if you want to compete, you know, some people say, yeah, I want to compete. I didn't do any basic classes. So if you want to compete, we're talking years. Like, it's not something you can just pull off within a year unless you drop everything. You stop working and you do salsa all day.
Okay,
and then you compete and then you win a trophy. So there's also the competition. There's people that want to go on vacation, but there's also the people that want to be good. Like, they want to go out and pull moves and stuff like that. Maybe 1 or 2 years starts to get interesting.
Yeah.
You know, 1 or 2 years of class, then you can start to have a bit of swag on the dance floor.
You're comfortable with your moves.
Here we
you
go.
Add your swag.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And the ladies go, oh, this is a good dancer, you know, about 1 or 2 years. But how about you? What do you think? What do you think?
I think it's, like you said, it's all relative, but it's definitely how much work you put into it. I mean, if you're coming to class and that's the only time you dance, then it might take you a bit longer to get comfortable with everything. If you're practicing at home, if you're going social dancing, even though you're not 100% comfortable with your moves, but you're going out there, you're being immersed in the dance,
yes.
You're dancing with different level dancers, I think that progresses your dancing.
I have people that tell me, I don't want to hit the dance floor, like the social dance floor or events. I want to wait to be good.
You know?
No. That's not the way it works, guys.
Wrong way of thinking.
Yes, because the sooner you hit the dance floor, the faster you'll get better.
Absolutely. And actually, I had a student say to me on Friday, it's the first time I came here because we had the practice night, and I feel like I progressed so much in one evening. And I was like, I told you.
Take notes.
And never be shy to dance with dancers that are above your level, because we've all been there. And if we didn't dance,
we would suck.
We would suck. No, because I did get that comment too. Oh, this must be boring for you. No, I've been there.
Yeah.
It's not boring.
And also, I one of my like best dances had nothing to do with the level of the person. Sometimes I had bizarre dances with very good dancers, and sometimes I had amazing dances with people that just started. It's just their energy. That's how you connect, how you smile, how you. So that's
more than just your feet and the moves.
Here we go, guys. So see you in the next video.